Hello, I'm Mike. AI improves every day, and today is no exception. We're going to use Claude projects as MCP agents. Before I get started, you might say, well, why do I care? And what does it do? Well, first of all, consider Claude projects as the brain that you train in your company knowledge, transcripts of your YouTube videos, or branding guidelines to. And then consider MCP agents as the hands that can use different tools to come up with the ultimate answer to whatever it is you need to do. For example, training in some YouTube transcripts and coming up with social media posts based on what you've said in your videos, or understanding your company's identity and proposing a bunch of draft replies to all your unread emails. Or how about looking at your brand guidelines and designing some awesome thumbnails for your business? Let's dive in. So we'll get started by downloading Claude Desktop. The first thing you'll notice is you can upgrade to connect your tools to Claude, so I'll go ahead and upgrade my plan to the Pro plan. Now with that done, you'll see I've unlocked a bunch of features, including trying integrations. So this is our first attempt at connecting the hands to our AI to use the tools. In the past, we'd have had to play around with files on our computer, download dependencies, update JSON files, and things would inevitably break when an update rolls out. No longer. Now it's really simple. I just go into Connect Tools to Claude right here, and I can browse through some of their integrations. Now, when I scroll down, you'll see there's a Zapier integration here, which is fantastic because Zapier has over 8,000 integrations, so it's kind of like one tool to rule them all. Let's connect. Now, straight away, you'll see there are just two steps. First of all, I need to click this URL to get a server URL and paste it in the second step. And look at that, I'm logged into Zapier and it's taking me straight to the page I need. I just click Create MCP Server and it's done. Now we'll add tools in a moment. I'm just going to click Connect and I've copied and pasted my MCP URL right here. Now you'll see it's just asking me for permission, which I'll allow Claude to connect to Zapier. If I drop down my tool set, you'll see Zapier is here with two tools presently. This is where I can start adding tools before we work on the brain, which is the project section of Claude. We'll start very simply by just adding one tool here. Now you'll see there are thousands of tools, but don't get overwhelmed. I'm going to type table and I'm going to go ahead and use Zapier Tables. Think of Zapier Tables as an overpowered spreadsheet you can use to store and retrieve any knowledge on the project you're working on. I'm just going to go ahead and add all Zapier Tables tools. Before we connect it, I'm just going to create a Zapier table and I'm going to call it social media posts. Description, creator, magic, social posts. Now, just like a normal spreadsheet, I'll add some fields. We'll start with a text field. We'll call it post. I'll make another field. We'll call it mentions. And as we're AI first all the way with this, I'll make another field. We'll use an AI field inside Zapier tables. We'll call this one long post. And then I need to create a prompt. As you'll see, OpenAI is included as an AI model. I'm going to start from scratch. I'll select data to be the post. Make a longer version of this that can be posted on LinkedIn in a professional tone. That sounds good to me. I'll click done and create. Look at this. Now we've got a place for a post, mentions, and a long post for LinkedIn. We're going to get two for the price of one when I set this up. Now back over in Zapier MCP, we'll just connect Zapier tables. And you'll see with one click, I've basically added all of these Zapier table tools to my AI's hands. Back over in Claude Desktop, you'll see this is immediately reflected by Zapier table tools all being selected. And you'll note that I can switch these on and off as I need if I don't want to use all the tools. So now we create a project. I'm going to pop open the sidebar and click into Projects. We'll call the project Creator Magic YouTube Posts. You will be responsible for creating amazing social media posts based on my YouTube content. There we go. That's a pretty good description for my first project. Let's create it. Now, this is where we add the brain to our AI. Of course, AI is great at knowing lots about everything, but we want to make sure it specifically knows what is appropriate to our project we're working on. So first of all, we prime it up by setting the project instructions. Think of this like a system prompt so our AI knows what it's doing every time we talk to this project. You are a world-class content creator that is responsible for creating amazing social media posts based on the content of my videos. Here's a broad overview on the Creator Magic YouTube channel, what works, what it's about, and what I want you to focus on. I've created a huge system prompt for my YouTube channel. I did this by summarizing a large amount of data from my channel using Google Gemini. And so I'll post that condensed prompt. We'll go ahead and save those instructions, and now you'll see it's trained in. Now we can still add project knowledge right here, and you've got the possibility to add lots of stuff. You can upload, add flat text content, connect to GitHub or Google Drive. In this case, I'm going to upload a bunch of files from my device, and you'll see they're all text files, flat text files of my YouTube videos. I've got transcripts of all my YouTube videos, so I'll select all of these files, click open, and boom, look at this. It's adding all of my YouTube transcripts, and it's only used 1% of my project capacity. Actually, it's increasing, but I should imagine by the time this is done, a very small amount of my project will be used. And look at this. Okay, we've had 17% of our project capacity used, and this is after running a YouTube channel for over 1 year, so that's pretty good. So with our project system prompt and all of these text files trained in, now we can prompt our AI, and it's going to go ahead and use its brain and its hands to use the tools that I've given it. I'd like you to make 5 posts based on my YouTube videos that I can post on the platform X. 140 characters in length, don't use hashtags, and make them attract a lot of attention. Once you've done that, please record them to a Zapier table. That's all I need to say. My AI has the brain and also the hands to use the MCP tools via my Zapier integration. You can see it's already searched my project. It's searching again to create compelling X posts based on specific videos. Now it has great content to work with. It's going to go ahead and use the Zapier table integration via the Zapier MCP to add them. And it's found the social media post table I just created. Now it's giving me all those posts. I'm just confirming to allow it to create records in my table. And you can see in real time, look at this. And you can see in real time, Claude is actually populating my Zapier table here. Look at this. As the table gets populated, the Zapier AI goes ahead and creates a long post for my LinkedIn as well. Now you can see Claude is wrapping up here, telling me that it's done everything. I've got the 5 posts for X, which will be 140 characters long, very, very short, ready for X. But most importantly, Zapier's AI right inside Zapier tables also generated me a long post for each one to also repurpose over to LinkedIn. This is definitely really, really cool. It made the post and the long post, but it missed out my mentions table, and I would love to at mention relevant companies that are mentioned in these posts. So let's go back to my Claude project. This is really great, but now I'd like you to go back over those posts you just added to the Zapier table and update the mentions field for each post and at tag any relevant companies that I should mention. That's all I have to say. My Claude project, along with the MCP agent, will know exactly what to do. Here we go. I'll help you update. It's asking for permission, and it's going to go ahead and find those records first. Perfect. Now I have all 5 posts. Let me update each one with relevant company mentions. Again, allowing the tool to go ahead and do this. Okay, and it's finished. Look at this. It's added Circle App, HeyGen, Zapier, Superbase, and YouTube creators as potential mentions for these posts it just made. This is pretty awesome. But let's not stop there. Let's go back to Zapier MCP and add some more tools to our AI's hands. We'll just add Gmail, all the available tools for my Gmail account, now in the AI's hands. And another one, it's as easy as clicking Add Tool, typing in the name of the tool, and clicking Slack. We'll add all tools. Okay, yes, it really is as easy as that to authorize your AI to access anything you want. I have a huge issue that my YouTube email gets absolutely pounded with opportunities. Some of them very low quality, some of them extremely high quality, but I haven't got time to sift through everything, so why don't I get Claude to do it for me? I created a new personal project which I'll call YouTube Leads. You are a world-class lead qualifier for a YouTube channel all about this, and you will find ways to respond to the leads. You'll either write a draft email or simply mark it as read if it's a low-quality lead or spam. That should be enough, and then below, I'm going to post that giga prompt about my YouTube channel. Now I'll attach a text document called leads.txt with a list of all the companies that I'd like to work with based on deep research that I did earlier on with AI. Now this prompt and this text file are the guiding light for my AI to decide what to do with my messy inbox. So now let's prompt it so my AI can use its brain and its hands to use the tools to make my life easy. Please make my life easy by looking at my Gmail and finding all emails that are unread and labeled YouTube leads, and then either draft a reply or, if they're low quality, simply mark them as read. Okay, already it says perfect. I can see you have the YouTube leads label with rocket emoji, and it's found 29 unread emails ready to work with it. It's found some high quality leads, Vibe Frame, an AI thumbnail tool, and it's already creating a draft reply here, which I can just allow it to do. can go over here and refresh my Gmail, and immediately I'll see in my inbox lots of draft replies being populated. Let's look at this one, for instance. Hi, Jazz. Thanks for reaching out. I'm interested in trying VibeFrame. And it goes on to say, I'd like to take you up on the trial. Also curious about the affiliate program. Look forward to testing it out. This is brilliant. My busy work sitting in an inbox is done for me by Claude Projects with MCP agents. This is AI orchestration in action using Zapier, which is the most connected AI orchestration platform. Now you'll see my agent has already found those low quality leads and is asking to use a tool to archive all those emails. Absolutely. So now it's going ahead and archiving all the emails that don't need a reply. And we can watch over here as my YouTube leads go from 22, boom, down to just 5. And you'll see those 5 are nicely replied to in draft form, of course. This is incredible and such a time saver for me. I'm sure it will be for you. Let's try one more Claude project with an MCP agent doing the work for me. All right, you'll see I've already hopped in, created the Creator Magic Brand Designer, and I'm going to give it a project instruction, which will be: you are a world-class designer, and your job is to create amazing-looking visuals and assets for Creator Magic based on the brand guidelines. Now we'll hop to my community, and we'll take a quick screenshot of this page. We'll go to my YouTube channel, and again, take a very quick screenshot of what that looks like. I'll download my logo from Google Drive. That should be enough for my agent to get the gist of things, so we'll drag and drop those images there, and you'll see they're retained as design knowledge. Now, you might have a PDF or something like that you could throw in with your brand guidelines, and that is even better. If you like what you see so far, throw a like and subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. Now let's give my agent the hands, and I bet you didn't think that Claude could use GPT image generator. Well, yes, it can, thanks to MCP agent abilities. So back here in my Zapier MCP control panel, I'll just add another tool and we'll search for OpenAI. There it is. Now we'll scroll down and we'll look for generate an image. Now, Zapier are always surprising me with what they add. If we actually click into this and look for the image model here, you'll see I can set a specific value for my MCP agent to always use in my Claude project. And instead of DALL-E 2, which is very old school by now, secretly under the hood, Zapier added the ability to use the GPT Image 1 generator. That is the latest generator, by the way, from OpenAI that's really, really cool. So I'm going to save it. And now you'll see here, as a tool, Claude can use ChatGPT Image 1 generator. I'm also going to add in Google Drive as a tool. We'll give it the ability to upload a file. We're going to set the folder here as AI orchestration and save it. Okay, so now my agent can generate with GPT Image 1 and save to the AI orchestration folder. Let's create an epic prompt. I'd like you to generate 4 thumbnails for my YouTube video. The brief is attached below. Use ChatGPT image generator to make the thumbnails and save them to my Google Drive. There you go. That's a pretty explicit prompt. I'll paste in the video brief for this video. Hit enter and let Claude Projects go to work with the MCP agent. It says, I will do it. It's already identified my brand colors here and it's already calling the ChatGPT image generator. This really tickles me that Claude is using the OpenAI image generator to make my thumbnails. And if we pop this open, we can see the instructions it's sending over using Zapier as the Zapier MCP intermediary to make things happen. This is really cool. You'll see that it's trying different concepts and different types of prompts. And now it seems to be all wrapped up, so let's check my Google Drive. And here we have it using my brand guidelines and the Creator Magic colors there. I can see it's generated 4 thumbnail ideas. Now, while I wouldn't use any of these straight out the box, they're definitely a good starting point for me to create a great thumbnail for my YouTube video. So there you go, from social media posts to organizing your inbox and even generating thumbnails and graphic assets based on your brand guidelines. I really think Claude Projects with MCP agents powered by Zapier can do an incredible amount for your business. Let me know how you'll be using this in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.